In this video, we're going to look at one of the arguments against the assertion that the brain is a computer. And this argument essentially says, no, the brain is not a computer, because if it were, that would then not leave any room for the soul. And I guess you could agree that that might be true, that if the brain were a computer, then that might not leave room for the soul, however you want to define that. But that doesn't necessarily mean that is the case, that the brain is not a computer. So in my mind, this could be an example of wishful thinking or motivated reasoning. Another example of that type of reasoning, that type of fallacy, would be if you were a smoker and you're thinking about whether smoking damages your health, you could say, well, no, smoking can't damage your health, because otherwise I would feel particularly uncomfortable. Well, yes, but that doesn't mean that it's true. So this is an example of motivated reasoning. And so in my mind, this particular objection to the brain not being a computer, that the brain isn't a computer, isn't really a very coherent argument.